Hi, my name is John Jennings. I'm the golf course superintendent of Shinnecock Hills Golf Club. I've been the golf course superintendent at Shinnecock for 6 years now. I've been in the turf industry for over 35, and I've been a golf course superintendent for 30 years this year. Today, we're going to take you around Shinnecock Hills Golf Club and show you our tournament preparation and the exciting challenges that we face on the golf course in getting things ready. And we hope that you enjoy this behind-the-scenes look at what goes into making a golf course really great for some of the world's greatest players. We've got a large property. It's 300 acres, and of that 300 acres, over 70 acres of it are maintained at under half an inch, all the way down to a tenth of an inch on the greens. Getting everything together and planning has been taken from a vision that we've had for a number of years to get in tournament conditions. The bunkers evolve over a long period of time. We get wind in the wintertime out of the northwest, which blows across, picks up the fine particulate, and then drops it off in the grass. We end up with some banks that become pretty severe, pretty steep, and it becomes a golfing challenge, which is great around the green surfaces, especially the way the greens come and run off to the edge and then drop down dramatically into the bunkers. But in order to maintain these steep surfaces, we use hover mowers and string trimmers around the edges. And again, that's not an easy task because, first of all, these machines are a bit cumbersome and a little bit heavy. But our staff makes them look effortlessly from the amount of time that they've spent training and operating these machines in order to get a fine finish that allows the golf ball to roll freely off an edge and into the bunker beneath it. These mowers operate on a cushion of air and just glide across while cutting require a great deal of skill. And again, just the coordination with our staff. You've got Samuel on the cleanup lap mower going around while Lubin is trimming the banks. Behind them, bunker rakers will come in and clean up the grass that falls within the bunker and re-rake it afterward. See Lubin moving a turning board back for Alan so he can turn his mower on it. Turning boards are set up on the edges so that way you don't have the friction from the mower turning on the grass and wearing it out throughout the season, especially during stressful times when we have dry periods and a lot of sun and it gets hot. But all these little pieces fit together in part of the greater picture to make the golf course playable for the day and for the week. Each morning there are so many components as our staff leaves the maintenance facility to come out, and between small mowers, large mowers, applications of plant protectants on the golf course, changing hole locations, all these little things come together and you have to figure out how to orchestrate them and stay ahead of play so that way the golfer isn't impacted by them while they're on the course. And that effort and coordination by both our staff but also the planning effort on our part to make sure that it's going to go. It's no different than getting ready for a sporting event. If you think of yourself as a football team, talking about a plan ahead of time, watching game film, getting the team together, painting a clear vision for them, and then executing that on the field. That's what we do every single day when we come out on the golf course.